Hi everyone, it's Miriam Ortiz Y Pino here for another edition of the Q&A session. I just realized I hit start before I took a sip of my coffee and I could really use one. So hang on 1 second while I sip. Ever have one of those days? It's been one of those days, everything happens. Okay, so I have been soliciting some questions and so far have only received one. So hopefully some people will join in and ask your question. Feel free to always send me your questions or post them on any of the Facebook ones, and then I will answer them next month if I don't get to them today. But you can visit morethanorganized.net. Lots of articles and resources there, but you can send me questions via the contact form there. Always love to answer them, and then I repost the videos later so you can get your answer when you need it. Hello, welcome. If you have a question, go ahead and put it in the comments. I can answer it from there. And I just realized I see that someone's watching me, but I can't actually see who it is. So welcome. I may be able to check in a minute, but from my platform here, I don't see it. Anyway, the first question I have for this month came from someone at a networking event, and they were mentioning that they set goals every year or every quarter or whenever they need to set a goal, but then they don't ever know how to actually achieve that goal. So I wanted to talk a little bit about how to actually get things achieved instead of just writing it down. So it's great that you set goals. That makes you better than 93% of the population. Writing that goal down makes you better than 97% of that population. And those people are more likely, or something like 48% more likely to actually achieve their goals if you just write it down. So that's the first thing I'd suggest. Actually write down your goal and post it where you can see it regularly. Those two things are going to get you easily 80% of the way there. The other thing you want to consider, and a lot of people don't even realize that it's a thing, but there are two different kinds of goals. There are habit goals and there are project goals. And you cannot treat them both the same way. And so that's part of the problem, is not actually understanding what a goal is. I like to think of goals as a list of things I'd like to achieve. And then I prioritize one of them at a time. So it's really hard to do a bunch of things all at the same time. So what you want to do is look at what you have going so far is your list of goals, and which one is going to get you the biggest bang for your buck. Which one, by doing it, is going to make the rest of them easier to do. That's a great place to start and way of thinking about it. But it is possible to do a habit goal and a project goal at the same time. So habit goals are things like, I want to work out more often. Well, how many times would that be? Would that be every day, go for a walk? Would that be 3 times a week, get to the gym? So that's a habit goal. That is something that is a recurring thing that you want to get into a routine about accomplishing so that you are more likely to do it. The more you practice that, the more it becomes automatic behavior that you're going to want to do over and over, and you're going to miss it if you skip a day. So that's a habit routine, and that requires some sort of tracking. And it requires a cue for starting it. So if you set something up like, I'm going to get healthier this year, and part of that is working out 4 days a week, you might want to put your running shoes and socks near the bottom of the bed so you pull them on right as you wake up instead of thinking about it and doing some other stuff first and then going and getting distracted and never getting around to going for a run. There's ways you can do it to set it up so that you are queued up, ready for the action, and it makes it easier to achieve that action for any given day. So you want to have a cue, you want to have a plan of what you're going to do. So if you're going to the gym, you're going to go to the gym and you have a way, what you need to take to the gym ready and waiting, and you go to the gym and you know what you're going to do on your way back. And you need to plan for obstacles. So what's going to happen if something comes up? Are you going to skip that day and go another day? Are you going to go later in the day? Are you just going to do a shorter workout at home? What are you going to do on that day where you can't make it all the way to the gym? or the car doesn't start. So you want to pre-plan some of the actions you're going to do if there's a problem. And you're going to want to set up a reward for why you're doing the thing. So it's super important to know why you've picked these goals in the first place. Why are you trying to get to the gym 4 days a week? What is that about? What's the ultimate goal of that? Is it to be healthier? Is it to be around for your grandkids? Is it to be able to play with your kids? Is it to be able to be more effective at work if you have ADD, to burn off some of that energy? Why are you trying to get to the gym 4 days a week? What's that ultimate goal? Do you just want six-pack abs? What is it? That's going to help keep you motivated. But then you also want to have a reward. So if you are shooting for 4 days a week at the gym and you make it there 16 times this month, maybe you get a reward of some sort. And rewards need to be something that you wouldn't do anyway, but that you would love. And can't be something that interferes with the results of that habit. So if your goal is actually to be healthier and getting to the gym is one of the habits that's going to help that, you don't want the reward to be ice cream, because that'll tank your results from going to the gym. But it could be a new shirt or a new workout outfit, or it could be going to the movies or spending time with friends, or it could be, you know, having a healthy dinner out with friends. There's ways to reward, but you need to know what the reward is ahead of time. So you're working towards getting that thing, that activity, that it's often a thing. I like it to be an experiential thing or a temporary thing. I buy flowers for myself a lot as the rewards, because I love flowers, but I don't necessarily go buy them for myself regularly unless they're attached to a reward for a habit formation. So that's that thing. You've got to have a reason why. You got to know what you're doing. You have to practice it. You have to plan for obstacles, and you have to have a reward. That's how you get habits done. And you have to realize that if you miss a time, you're going to do it again. You're going to start over. You're going to practice. You're going to keep going. That's how those things happen. There's a consistency involved, much more than an actual number of times before it becomes automatic behavior, and you can do that. Project goals, on the other hand, require a little more planning, and you don't want to work on more than one at a time, because you're going to get most of them finished one at a time. And by one at a time, I mean kind of you're going to think about them sequentially. So if your goal is to rearrange the living room so that you have room for new furniture that's coming in, maybe you work on that for 45 minutes and get it done. And then you can work on the next project. But if your goal is something more like clean out the garage, you are going to need to plan that, because that's more than one session. That takes a few times. But you don't want to clean out the garage and the kitchen and reorganize your closet all in the same weekend. You want to do one and then the next and then the next one. And these kinds of projects, same with work projects, if you're launching an event or holding a workshop or something, or a new endeavor at work, you need to back out the time. So you see when the deadline is and how much work needs to happen and what resources you need to get it done. And you need to actually map it out to see where the conflicts arise and see where time needs to happen. One of the mistakes I see a lot of my clients make is they think the project is more important than all the routine things that have to happen to keep a minimum level of efficiency going in the rest of their life. So they go all in and skip getting all the routine stuff done. What you want to do instead is create as many routines as possible and do them all. Some of them may get foreshortened. So you, instead of spending 20 minutes on email, you may spend 10. Instead of writing 4 blog posts this week, maybe you just post 3 of the ones that you already had. There's a lot of different things you can do to make them a little bit shorter and more consolidated, but you still do them. You still touch base with all your various routines every day as much as possible. But what that does is make you more efficient and frees up time to work on a block of time, like a 90-minute to 3-hour session to work on that project. So you have a map, you have some bigger chunks of time available during your day that you block out to work on them, and that's how you get things done. Having a little bit of accountability or a reward built into project tasks too can help. It's a little bit different in that there's a definite end date when it's a project. And so just take the time to go ahead and map out the time. That's what happens. People don't map out the time. I want to write a book this year. And then in November, they're like, oh, I never got around to starting because I was doing all these other little things that weren't that important to me. But what if instead you had blocked out 2 hours a week to work on a book or 20 minutes a day? And then by November, you would have had it done. So know that they're the two kinds of goals, and sometimes they overlap. But mostly you just want to have a plan and work the plan. It's just like any other goal. So I find it funny that people say they don't know how to achieve goals. And yet if you say, let's go on vacation, plan a vacation, they'll plan a vacation, go on vacation and have that done. That's a goal. Technically, that would be a goal. It's a plan of attack to achieve a desired outcome. That's all a goal is. So just map it out and see what happens. And don't beat yourself up for not achieving things to perfection. Better done than perfect. Creates feedback loops that you can achieve your goals and get better all the time. That's the other thing that's really handy. And I talked about it in the More Than Organized Monday this week as well, that be better mindset. Instead of being perfect or waiting till situation is exactly right, you just go ahead and start and see where it leads. And you think about it in terms of, I want to be better about it this week. Oh, I only made it to the gym 3 times last week. I'm going to be better next week, and I'm going to get there 4 times. That's the kind of thing you want to do, is constantly remind yourself that you're working on something. You're working towards something, and you just want to be better about it. Okay, well, usually I hang out for about half an hour, but I'm not seeing any new questions come in. Let me just check one other spot that people might have sent questions to see if anything came up. No, not there. Check this one other spot. I hope there's no feedback loop. Okay. No one posted any questions. All right, I guess I'm done for January. In the future, I do these Q&A sessions once a month on the second Thursday at 5 p.m. Mountain Time. That is 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And you can always send the questions ahead of time or just post them here below this video, and I'll get to them next time. And thanks for joining me. Hope this was helpful, and let me know what your goal is. Post it in the comments. I'd love to hear what you're working on right now. All right, thanks for joining me. Take care, see you next month. Bye-bye.